Hi, and welcome to the No Name Prayer Podcast. I am your host, Monica. Let us begin our reflection for today from the book, There's Power in Your Tongue, by Maria Vadia. Today's reflection is, anger will derail you. Psalm 4, verse 4. Be angry, but sin not. Commune with your own hearts on your beds and be silent. Usually when we're angry and we speak, nasty words come out of our mouths. Words packed with bitterness and resentments, insults and curses, bad words that bring death and not life. We would do well to heed the advice of James in chapter 1, verse 19. Know this, my beloved brethren. Let every man be quick to hear, slow to speak, slow to anger, for the anger of men does not work the righteousness of God. What is the solution? Verse 21 says, receive with meekness the implanted word, which is able to save your souls. Once again, we are to fill up with the word and allow it to transform our lives. We also need to get filled with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gives us self-control. For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power and love and self-control. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. We're not alone in this. Our helper will help us when we call on him, and he'll help us control our tongues. In Galatians 5, verse 23, we see self-control as the ninth-fold fruit of the Holy Spirit. If you have the Holy Spirit, you have self-control. Learn to release it. Proverbs 15, verse 1 says, a soft answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. Anger brings about more anger in yourself and others. It's a vicious cycle that needs to be broken. Verse 18 says, a hot-tempered man stirs up strife, but he who is slow to anger quiets contention. When we keep our peace and give a soft answer, contention is ended. Anger is one of the doorways through which the enemy comes in. This is another reason why we shouldn't stay angry or nurse our anger. Ephesians 4 verses 26 to 27 says, be angry but do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger and give no opportunity to the devil. In other words, we will get angry at times, but don't nurse it. Let it go, especially before the day is over. Forgive that person and release him or her over to the Lord. Anger is an invitation for demonic activity. If you stay angry long enough, you're giving the devil an opportunity to steal, kill, and destroy in your life. The enemy comes in with nothing good for you. He might bring depression, fear, sickness, lies, and anxiety, just to name some of the garbage that he brings when there's an open door. I know people that are bound by anger. They have no peace in their lives. With their words, they kill. Later, they're sorry, but the harm has been done. In Christ, there's another way to live. He's come to set us free. He's the truth that sets us free. There's freedom in Christ from that anger. We can actually change our tongues from an instrument of death to an instrument of life by His grace. Proverbs 22 verses 24 and 25 says, make no friendship with a man given to anger, nor go with a wrathful man, lest you learn his ways and entangle yourself in a snare. I believe you can definitely pick up the bad from people. The saying, a rotten apple spoils the rest, has a lot of truth to it. However, there can also be a transference of evil spirits when ties are formed with angry people. It's obvious in some families that there's a lot of anger in the family tree. And only the Lord Jesus can break that curse and bring freedom and transformation. Jesus is always the solution. He's already dealt with all of our garbage at the cross, and if we repent and ask Him for help, He will do it. Recently, I was so angry with somebody, and with good reason. I was tempted to call this person back on the telephone and just tell them what a rotten human being this person was. I had literally my hand on the phone to make the call. But by God's grace, I didn't. Instead, I forgave and released this person to the Lord and asked the Lord to bless this person. I spoke with the Lord and told Him, "You are the one that defends me. I don't have to defend myself. I give up my right to prove I was right. I release once again this matter into Your hands." About 10 minutes later, the phone rang, and behold, it's the same person calling me back and apologizing. The Holy Spirit Himself, with His convicting power, touched this person. I didn't have to call back in anger to use my tongue in the wrong way. I didn't have to play God to convince this person of wrongdoing. When I let go, the Holy Spirit was freed to do His work. The Apostle Paul says in Romans 12, verse 21, "Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good." When we forgive and refuse to give into anger, we are overcoming evil with good. Praise the Lord. Father God, I thank You for this reflection today. I thank You for the gift that You have given Maria Vadia to write this book and all the knowledge that You have given her, because now we are able to reflect on this and read it and understand the power of our tongue, the power of our words. Lord, I ask You, Lord, to break every chain in my family tree, Lord. Break the chains of our family tree, Lord. Break the chains of anger, resentment, grudges, Lord. Lust, Lord. Anything, Lord, that does not come from You, Lord. We don't want it, Lord. We renounce any spirit that we have opened the doors to, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We ask for Your peace, Lord. We belong to You. We give You everything, all that we have, all that we are, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We cover ourselves with the precious blood of Jesus. And I thank You for, once again, Lord, for Your love, Your mercy, for your peace, for Your forgiveness, Lord. I ask You, Lord, I give You my heart, Lord. And I ask You to remove any unforgiveness, any hurt, any brokenness, Lord, from there. I ask for Your healing. Just Your healing, Lord. Your healing and Your love. We ask You to take over, Lord, to take over everything that we are, everything, Lord. From head to toe, Lord, we belong to You. Thank You for listening. Thank You for being here. Today is February 1st. We are going to be praying the novena as well. I'm going to do that on a separate recording. Remember, we are going to do the novena of Our Lady of Lourdes for February. So if you guys are interested, be on the lookout for that. That being said, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Be positive. Don't let anything negative, any bad feelings, any bad thoughts get you down. Keep fighting. Keep fighting the good fight. God is good. Surrender it all to Him. I know it's hard. I know sometimes, you know, we're hurt, we're sad, and we think about things that maybe happened before and we have not been able to heal from it. But we gotta keep going. Thank you for listening. Have a wonderful day. Remember to follow, subscribe to the Spotify page and or Apple, wherever you're listening from. Share with a friend. Give me a good rating. When I say us, know that I'm talking about, you know, my teammates here. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, the Holy Spirit. So give us a good rating. Have a wonderful day. God bless you. Pray for me, and I will pray for you.